Oh, fuck it. The music's kicking and we're going. Oh. Yeah. Let me know how my settings are. Music compared to game and all that. Alright, what's up, guys? 6 o'clock. Welcome back to Amped Freestyle Snowboarding. Let me actually close a bunch of these other tabs. Alright, so, I don't know, I've actually been kind of remembering the music from Amped recently, because Amped, if you remember, is basically a radio station with a game attached to it. I mean, you've got 6 inbuilt soundtracks, 6 different genres, all with a ton of music to them. And I definitely remember the emo playlist, so we'll probably be starting out with that, because this was that late 90s, early 2000s emo, where it wasn't, you know, scene kids dyeing their hair black and wearing shitty tattoos. This was, you know, just kind of like a pop punk type of thing. So I think we'll stick with emo for a bit. But sound volume's fine. Thanks, Bowser from Sonic 3. Man, that was a mega crossover. Like, I couldn't remember it. They got everyone. They got Mario. They got Donkey Kong. Oh, man. Bad joke. So I loaded the game up yesterday. This I've actually played a little bit beforehand, but my save file was just gone. Which means I'd have to play it again. So yesterday I messed around with the levels. This was the player I was playing yesterday, but so I don't have any progress in this game technically. Wait, hold on. Backspace, duh. So what do I remember from Amped? Amped was a game I had mixed feelings about. Amped, and especially its sequel, Amped 2, were games that, technically and functionally, they were fine, maybe a little clunky, but the challenges were so annoying. The actual gameplay was fine, just playing for high scores was good, but the challenges I remember being really bad. We're gonna start pretty much rounded out here. If I remember right, I haven't rewatched my videos or whatever, but if I remember right, I barely put any points into speed. So I think that's probably gonna be the same thing we're gonna do again. My hope is that maybe some of you played the game or have looked at it since, because if I remember, my LP was kind of just me versus the game, you know? I mean, I get that it's, you know, different genders or whatever, different proportions, but, that's just weird. Not gonna put a sheesh ton of, work into my character here at the start, but especially after Amped 2, I had a couple thoughts in mind about maybe how to conquer Amped 1 a bit better. I must have a Milo or a Bean. Okay, whatever. So, I'm gonna play the game again, and we're gonna see how it goes. Right. I didn't really mess with snowboards or anything my first time around. I actually didn't really realize they changed your stats up until I was sort of deeper into the game. Let's go with that. And also, I want you guys to let me know if the stream starts lagging or whatever, because sometimes my CPU just shoots up through the roof. And, then my stream starts clipping and shit, and there's not really a ton I can do during that, so I don't want to be just trucking ahead while you guys are, stuck watching frames, so. So I'm actually gonna pause my stream in the background. I'm still looking at chat, but. So yeah, maybe this time I'll be a little more knowledgeable about what to do, about how to go about these, challenges. So we're gonna start up with Brighton 1. Felix, this game is awesome, seen as how I snowboard IRL. Do you? You were there for the first 2 Let's Play videos. Remember you read the back of the booklet? It was like 10 reasons to play Amped, and it was like, your leg is broke, or the music's good, or, I don't know, you're under house arrest or some shit like that. If I remember right, you can go into sound, yeah, and you can see what song is playing. You know what, let's crank the music up more. The music is why I wanted to go back. Because like I said, that's actually a little loud. I mean, I set my sentence perfectly. Fuck it. I did really dumb there. But, I got back in kind of that amped emo mood, and I, you know, picked up old albums I hadn't really listened to in that genre, like the, if you remember, like, the Get Up Kids or bands kind of like that. Alright, so... the good thing going in is I remember all the controls. Because it's pretty standard. I even remember, like, you hit the triggers in the air to kind of shift your stance and not die. The thing about Amped 1 is you had to jump really late. Because if you try to do a front flip or a back flip, you can't jump halfway up the ramp like other games. You have to jump right up at the top. Your character starts off with no stats. So the thing about Amped and Amped 2, and especially what I'm feeling, especially having done Amped 2 first, or having done Amped 2 now, you know, when I first LP'd Amped 1, I hadn't played Amped 2 yet, is that in this game, there's two ways to spin and flip and two ways to do your tricks. One way is, you know, to spin and flip is to use the left thumbstick, and one way is to use the D-pad. And then the two ways to do tricks are, one way is to use the face buttons, and one way is to use the right thumbstick. And I remember, you know, during the LP, when I first played Amped, I stuck to the D-pad and the face buttons. Because those were kind of how I do tricks in, like, SSX, you know. You can't pre-wind, you know, in the older SSX games with the thumbsticks. You had to use the D-pad, so that's what I was used to. The thing is, then in Amped 2, it forced you to use the thumbsticks only, which I kind of hated for a bit. But, yeah, let's stay balanced for now. Oh, yeah, these weird little things. I have no idea how long the stream will go. It's not like I'll, like, go a level and then stop or whatever. I'm hoping to get back to some of the harder parts so you guys can watch, you know, real-time some of the crap that you have to go with. Because, like I said, just playing for high scores... Amped's a pretty fun game. I'm pretty sure I didn't get the full high scores. Was there a way to, So no, I just need to get more media points. But yeah, just riding down is pretty fun. But, so, I was forced to use the thumbsticks for Amped 2, so now coming back to Amped 1, I'm kind of defaulting to using the thumbsticks, and I think it's... from what I was playing yesterday, I think it actually was working out pretty well. You just kind of ride up to a thing and you push in the thumbsticks and you just do a cool flip or whatever. So I think I was too harsh and unwilling to change the first time around. I crossed some wires in my head. I meant to hit the grind button, which is B. You can kind of see a little of the clunkiness, like, these logs are so high up off the ground, you have to, like, get a running, you know, boost to jump up onto them. If I remember right, rail tricks were the way to go, because, like, if you got on a log, it gave you points based on the length you were grinding, so if you went slow enough, you could get a shit ton of points, and the media guys double whatever point total you get. So, boom, like... I got, you know, 120,000 from that alone. Now, the big thing about Amped, from what I can remember, and what I was seeing yesterday and seeing today, is sometimes you'll just get insane extra point bonuses for landing something well. Like, that first time, well, that was a media guy. I still haven't figured out half pipes. It's like, you just, like, lose your speed at an arbitrary area up there, but... like, sometimes, right there, I got, like, 8,000 points of, landing bonus. There, it doubled, so I only got 2,000, you know, like, I don't really know, I have a few thoughts, and especially after Amped 2, which had its style mechanic, and, really made it more clear where the points come from. You know, you'll see that you're about to get 40,000 extra points if you do a trick just right. In that game, but in this one, it's pretty much blind to you. But there definitely are a couple mechanics that are going on. I think there's a mechanic about just finishing a trick before you land, like when I've done spins or flips and just finished before I landed, I'm not gonna land this one. If I had like 10 more feet to jump and trick, I'd have got a pretty decent landing bonus on that. But also, I swear there's a near miss. See, what the fuck was that? I went from 2,000 to 22,000. I swear there's a near miss thing. Because, like, on these jumps, it's kind of hard to get near misses. But on the track Altabahn, if you guys remember that, that was, like, a more natural kind of landscape. And so it wasn't a lot of, you know, shaped ramps. It was, you know, jumping off the top of a cliff or whatever, you know, flat cliff, but then you jump off and there's nothing under you, so you do a cool trick. And there, you can jump and, you know, be just up above the ground for a bit as you clear over the cliff. And on that track, I was more consistently getting bigger landing bonuses, or bigger bonuses. Hey, Bob. You know, I could probably do a Discord call for this as well, because I'm just running it out of OBS, but right now I'm sort of in the re-explaining thing. I was talking about how, you know, revisiting this after we played Amped 2 as well, and Amped 2 made a lot of things more clear, is affecting kind of how I see how this game works, and maybe is going to make me do better at it the second time. Because, like, you remember the style system from Amped 2, Bob? I think there's a rudimentary thing in this game like that, but of course in this game they don't tell you any of that. Oh god. Sometimes you just don't jump. No, that would mean that was my fault, but... So, yeah, I think there's definitely a close call landing bonus. Like, this... Yeah, I went from 4,000 to 15,000 because I just sort of coasted over the top of that mound. Oh god, I hate half pipes. I have still not figured out half pipes. Fireball Disaster, am I going to play the SSX games? Yes, eventually. I mean, they are bread and butter. I grew up with them. I love them. I still play SSX 3 quite a lot. The only thing is, you know, I started the series to cover all the other kinds of games that weren't Tony Hawk or SSX. And, well, I've been at this for 5 years now because I've been kind of slowing down recently. I mean, I still have a shit ton of PlayStation 1 stuff to go back to. But eventually, I'll cover the SSX games. I mean, I just love them so much. I have so much to say about them, so much to show off. And a thing I remember about Amped 1, during the sponsor events, and hold on, I'm going to close my window. There's a couple cars outside in the parking lot that are pretty damn loud. The thing about Amped 1 is these sponsor events, yeah, they have preferences, but... They'll give you points for basically any big trick. So this guy likes rails, so I'm gonna do some sick rail stuff, and he's gonna be like, that's cool. But then I'm gonna come over here and do some sick, oh god, I'm gonna crash this, but I'm gonna do some sick air stuff, and he's gonna think that's just as neat. Really like your Whiteout Let's Play since I used to have it for the PC. Whiteout was for PC? Huh. To me, that kind of seems like an odd game to put on PC. It was just really okay, but hey, if it worked out. Oh, perfect, baby. Baby, baby, baby. Oh! This is gonna, like, fill the bar the entire way. Yes! Or, by that, I mean fill about 1.5 segments. But, yeah, see, like, I did an air trick, and the guy went fucking wild. Oh, fuck. But, yeah, like, right here, to pause again, I don't want to do this too much, but I like the sound of this song. It's an early Yellow Card song before they really took off. Trembling by Yellow Card. I'm playing the emo playlist because, I mean, God, there's just so many great songs in that. And I've been kind of in that mood recently. Anniversary, Get Up Kids, Jazz June. I picked up Jazz June and Game Face from this game. I like the songs I heard from those bands and I picked their albums up. I actually had the anniversary album from a friend in high school, and Get Up Kids as well. I'm gonna fuck this up right before the end. Oh, not right. Amped 1 starts off pretty lenient. It only really starts to screw you about halfway through. So, like I've said several times, playing the game for high scores or for the sponsor events is fun. It's fun. It's fun doing different stuff, but you get to the pro events and that's where this game kind of becomes bullshit. And then the second game, they have those photograph challenges, like follow the path and do stupid shit. And that sucked as well. There were snowmen, you know, in these levels, but I don't think I'm going to do that. Honestly, though, I might make a snowman guide just because no one else has done so. And you know me, I like to fill holes in the knowledge gap of the internet. And while there's some text guides for the snowmen, there's no video guides. And man, I think there should be, you know. So if there's one thing that comes out of this, maybe I'll make some addendums to my amped Let's Play and do some snowman guides. Hey, what's up, Zyzoa? Oh shit, get up, kids. Holiday, here we go. You probably can't hear the music that well. I mean, if I turn it up, I'd have to turn me up. But, you know, I'll roll with this for a bit. Maybe I'll switch it over to some of the other genres. I just can't give enough love to the soundtrack these guys picked. Like, EA Sports Big picked some really good soundtracks for their games. Hey, buddy, I want it on that rail. But Amped 1 and Amped 2, and I think Amped 3, though I don't really remember it that well. They just knocked it out of the park with the selection. Oh, God. Like I said, it's still kind of a clunky game. You hit a rail, you know, the wrong way, and you just get wrecked. Oh God, please keep your balance. I was about to lose it. Yeah, I did this in the Let's Play, but like, you do that one rail and you've won this first Snow Summit course. See, like, that was just something that happened. Hey, and I doubled the points. I was in the media goal, even though I didn't think it was. Oh, shit, I almost did a sick transfer. Oh, get on. Eh, it's kind of hard to aim stuff. But yeah, I'm liking doing the thumbsticks. I'm not going to land this. Fuck. I don't have the points yet. But yeah, I like doing the thumbsticks. I just kind of pay attention to my landing bonuses and such, because, like I said, sometimes I'll gain 1,000, sometimes I'll gain 10,000. I think a few times I actually go backwards in points, which I don't know what that means. Maybe I land it, like, so bad that people's opinion of how cool I am in the air changes once I land. Did I miss anyone? Nope. Alt F4, Zyzoa, I think I said hi to you. 3 new skill points, media coverage. Yeah, we'll just do a little in speed, but actually, no, I think balance is pretty important. You saw I almost wiped out on that rail, and it's cool to do big grinds. It's not cool to try and grind and just fall over and die everywhere. Alright, I think I mostly explained my opinion of the series and how I did the first time and how I'm feeling this time, so now we'll just ride and have fun, and you guys will be along with me. Hey, yo, what is up, a Joseph Rikus? Joseph, Joseph, Joseph. We are playing Amped 1, and at the beginning, we're just charging through it. High scores, sponsors. I mean, you don't get into the pros until a little bit later in the game. Like spins and flips. Oh, but you guys said the song was good, so like I said, Holiday by the Get Up Kids. Fireball Disaster, oh my god, I loved Twisted Edge. It was weird. Like, 1080 Snowboarding was a much better game, but Twisted Edge just was strange, but good, kinda. Like, I heard of Twisted Edge. It's kinda obscure. There were copies. I had a copy, but man, if/when I get back to the N64 stuff, I need to show that game, because everyone knows 1080, no one knows Twisted Edge. It's perfect material. Hell, I can do Project 64, probably, on my laptop, and, Oh, shit. Like, Wow, only 3,000? I was thinking because of the near miss, I was going to get a ton. See, like, I have theories, but I can't 100% prove any of them. But look, 1,500 to 13,000. This is insane. Like, I wish I could harness this power for good and not neutral. Oh, crash. My stream title is misspelled. Oh, shit, it is. Hi, welcome to the Steel Donut. Today we're looking at people's YouTube stream titles. You scored a preferred parking pass. I remember us talking about how the rewards you get early on are really kind of weird. It kind of adds some charm. Like, you really do start out a nobody, and you bust sick tricks and get, like, a free hot dog. Or, like, I don't know, some stickers. Or here, you know, a free parking pass. But, then you get a pro, and, you start getting actual rewards, like clothes. Crispy Ride and Iris Rep. God, I can remember lines from our LPs, like, you, Bob, you were like, he reps irises? What does that mean? But, it's looking like I have some tweaks available at the start. If I remember right, I think it's nose grab and tail grabs, because you get tweaks from beating the Pro 1 events. And, yeah, I mean, there are six grabs that correspond to the thumbstick perfectly. Like, you know, obviously you push up, it'll be a nose grab, but it's kind of like where your hand goes. So right now I'd push, like, back right, and my guy would reach his hand back and grab the right side, which I think will be a still fish. Like, perfect. Like, yeah, it really syncopates well with the thumbsticks, just, I was used to the buttons. And yeah, like I said, I didn't really utilize it that well, but, I mean, first time around, wow, how did I land that? Holy shit. That was the most forgiving thing this game has ever done. I'm jumping too early, repeatedly. Yeah, I trashed that event. Sometimes you just do bad, like, 1080 has a really great soundtrack, the original 1080. I don't remember the original that well, just because, again, N64 days. I played Avalanche a couple years ago as well. God, I can't believe it's a couple years ago. Like, 2016, how many games did I Let's Play? Like, four in all of 2016, I think. No, it was Whiteout rolled into 2016, and then I did Tony Hawk Downhill Jam, Yanya, BMX Triple X, took a break, then Disney Skate, and started Carve up late. But either way, like, you know, I've definitely been slowing down just because I've been becoming an adult and all that. God, almost 5 years, bros. Like, July 2017, I'll have been doing this series for 5 years. Like, I was a little baby back then. I remember. I'd gone through freshman year of college and felt like I accomplished nothing, so I started LPs in the summer with my bros, and it's just been taking on a life of its own from there. Mind of its own, I guess. Oh, we're back to Get Up Kids. This is, see, the thing about this game is that, you know, when they feature an artist, they'll pull, like, 4 or 5 songs from one album. So Get Up Kids in this game, they have, 4 songs, I think, from their Something to Write Home About album. Holiday, Action in Action, Company Dime, 10 Minutes, yeah, I think 4. Jazz June has 2, Game Face has 2, Anniversary has 3, I think. This band called, I think either By a Thread, or that might be one of the songs by them. When it shows up, I'll see them. This one band has, like, almost half of an album on this game. Oh god, I'm gonna crash. Another thing about Amped, it crashes you if you land sideways, but, like, if you're sideways on a rail when it ends, it dumps you out sideways. So, sometimes you're, just a little SOL. Which, again, isn't a huge problem when you're just riding down. But in the pro events, that can get really annoying. See, this guy likes rails. Oh, fuck me. Shit. Is my profile name a variation of the Time Slitters Robot? Yes, 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 yes. There is a, multiplayer character in Time Splitters 3 called Incetic SDK 12. Took the Incetic part and put 47 on the end. Time Splitters was huge to my friend Sean and I. He's gone by many names in the videos. I think he was just Sean. But holy shit, Time Splitters 2 and 3 were huge to us back then. Damn, it's a fun game, you know? Ever tried Infinite Air? Mark McMorris? No, I don't have modern consoles, so I haven't played Steep or Infinite Air. I think Steep's on PC, so I could maybe try that, but no, I haven't kept up with modern sports games. I'm vintage. I'm old school. Maybe after Gunny's Gulch I can maybe swap it to a different genre. Because, I mean, this game has a big rock thing, electronica thing, punk. They actually have, and this is only really, going to be a shock to Bob as well. They actually have a couple Boy Sets Fire songs from their first album. Two of the more okay ones. Actually, In Hope's pretty good, but another song that's just alright. Wouldn't have been the ones that I'd have picked, but hey, you know, in an alternate universe, I discovered Boy Sets Fire through these guys rather than 1080 Avalanche. I might not have, though. I mean, they have Rookie in 1080 Avalanche, and that was really the song that caught my eardrums. Oh, yeah, I'm just tearing it up. Oh, right, yeah, and I did drop the C. I don't know why, just dropping the C seemed cooler to me. God, there's so many, alternate paths on these levels that I don't really take. I kind of stick to what works, and there's a ton of shit that could maybe work, but I'll probably end up using the same tricking lines as I did it back in the LP. So that was a pretty decent landing bonus. I got 8,000. Oh shit, I tricked too much. Playing Amped 1 since I was a kid, love snowboarding games. Alright, well, if you remember it, when I hit the point where I start having trouble, hopefully maybe you can help me out, because this game gets kind of bullshit later on. That's, I think everyone can agree to that. Two favorite video games of all time? Yeah. God, they were so good. Time Splitters Future Perfect online, on Xbox Live? Oh my god, that was so fun. we'd make ridiculous maps. Crazy maps. There was ways to break the map editor and make, stuff that you definitely weren't supposed to do. And, so fun. Halo 2, Time Splitters Future Perfect. Back then, probably Amped 2 on Xbox Live would have been pretty sweet as well. I never got to experience that. But, well, I was thinking I'd get some cool bonus for that. Likes half pipes. See, the thing about half pipes in this game is, I don't know, you have to hit the perfect line. If you kind of mess up a little, you start slowing down, and then your tricks kind of suck, and then you start not doing too well in the half pipe. I mean, I'm kind of making it work now, but like I said, I practiced some yesterday. I played this game some yesterday. Played Shaun White Snowboarding. Let's see. Basically, once I got the Xbox 360, I was pretty much in full Halo mode. So I played Halo 2 till Halo 3 came out, played Halo 3 till Reach came out. But I did play Amped 3 for a little bit. Not enough to really remember it, but Amped 3 was... Maybe I should revisit it. It was pretty wacky. I don't remember the quality of it, but that was pretty much the only Xbox 360, PS3 snowboarding game, and on extreme sports game really, except for Pure. New level available? Yeah, congrats! I'm a shop rider now, so we're gonna go back and do some sick pro events. again, the pro events are going to start pretty easy, but they're going to ramp up into annoying. Amp 3 was bad. Like I said, I kind of half remember how it was. I remember, like, you were able to hop on a snowmobile and basically drive back up the mountain if you'd really fucked something up, so that was probably a cool feature. Oh, yeah, and they had, like, the hang gliding and inner tubes. Maybe I just have rosy memories, but seemed like it added a bunch of fun options. It was pretty slow going, though. Like, they had kind of a story that made you go through a bunch of challenges to really get off and moving. And I remember spending most of a night just kind of trying to get to where I could really free roam. So yeah, pro challenges, if people haven't seen me play or don't remember, the pro is going to ride forward and do tricks off a bunch of different places, and you have to beat his point totals at those. In Amped 3, you actually have 3 free misses, and then on the 4th, in Amped 1, you actually have 3 free misses, and on the 4th miss, you fail, which is really lenient. Back in the LP, there were some events that I couldn't win without missing 3 of the things on, so if I could only miss 2, like they do in Amped 2, oh god, I don't know if I'd beaten all of those, but yeah, so you have to beat the pro, which at the start is pretty easy, but pretty quick, not always working the same way landing bonuses are going to kind of bite you in the ass. What console is this on? Xbox. Hey, what's up, Saudi Craftier and JH Lego Vids? I don't know if I said hey to you. This is a pretty good turnout. You know, recently kind of on Twitch, well, I was having streaming problems. Either Twitch or Elgato software was giving me the biz. That's all I needed, right? I keep hitting level select immediately. Like, so, yeah, here, let's back out. And we'll swap to a different soundtrack. And, well, this is Blank Tester's Xbox, so I have some System of a Down albums and The Hunter by Mastodon, but I kind of associate those with a different snowboarding game now. The trans world, trans whatever world, fuck. That game I put the soundtracks on, so let's do some punk. I almost threw it all away. That's where that song was going. Alright, so now that I'm a pro, and I need to remember to do this time, during my LP, I completely forgot to go upgrade my snowboard, like, at all. Like, now that I'm a pro, you can go over to the right, and you get a set of boards that give you a bit better stats. Actually, not super better at this point. Once you unlock the second tier of pro, it'll give you better, but, like, I need to remember to actually do these. I completely passed these up back in the LP. There was probably someone screaming at their screen. Let me go do this. I've never really seen how much putting points into Switch affects things. Like, I've never seen, like, if you keep Switch low, do you just, like, be able to flip during that? I need to get back into Gunny's Gold too, because I don't think I did the pro event in that. I need to get Amped 1, it's really expensive for a sealed copy. Is the game pirated? Nope, I'm playing this on original console. I had a video game store back where I lived, high school and such, that pretty much always had copies of basically anything. Vintage stock, it was actually really good. Now over here in Denver, there's really not much for used games. Like, I was lucky, but, oh god, see, I barely put any points into speed, and I'm already going so fast I almost fly by some of these trick things. But yeah, I always play original console hardware. Maybe for Nintendo 64 stuff I'd emulate it, but emulating PS2, PS1 is a little too much of a hassle for me, I think. See, like, the thing about this game is also, you don't have to beat the last pro event, or last pro trick, so I ride ahead and I just win. Do I sell Amped 1? I have a copy. I'm playing it right now. probably not going to sell it, though. Yeah, I need to check that all I'm leaving behind are the Explore challenges. Wait. Emo playlist is still going. Okay, right. The global option is not the same as the career-specific option. So now we're playing the punk playlist. Yeah, actually, I don't know if punk would be different enough. Let's do ska, reggae, surf rock. If I'm the ska, reggae, surf rock playlist in Amped 2 was really good. It introduced me to a band called the Zigglers, which they've got some songs in this game as well, but I don't think I really paid attention to this genre during this game. Gunny's Gulch. I gotta get back into Gunny's Gulch. Yeah, I can. I've searched for a while now. Still can't find a seller. I don't want to doubt you, but let me just jump on Amazon really quick. Boom, boom. More buying choices. 213 used and new offers. Amped Freestyle Snowboarding. I'm seeing it for $170. I mean, that's without shipping, but yeah, just hop on Amazon. I think Amazon will have options. Oh. If you need a PAL option, I don't know. I mean, Amazon.UK might have options. I don't know, though. God. It amazes me, getting a little off topic, like, I still barely touched PlayStation 1 and N64 games, and, like, that's when the extreme sports thingy really started, so there's a ton of games. Oh, see, I kind of thought I'd get a landing bonus. 2 of 4, so, like, well, this is probably the first pro challenge you do, because it's on the level you become a pro, or you unlock the first tier, but you could literally just ride past 3 of these thingies and only do 1. Like, in Amped 2, they definitely, making it so you had to beat the last pro jump to beat the event was a mixed bag. I mean, it made sense, but of course, every jump could screw you, and it sucked doing well and then fucking that up, but I could see why they did it. Ah, I hit level select. Oh my god. I don't think I'm doing the sponsor things. I'm gonna jump back in. Oh no. That's all I'd be able to do on a... I have 360... Yeah. I think Amped 1 and 2 are backwards compatible. Because... Definitely, yeah. I believe they both are. Brighton 2. It's kind of weird you go to Brighton, you know, both times before you even go to Stratton or Altabahn. Hey, Ren Hollow. It seems, I don't know how much the delay is. Seems like you guys are conversing before I get my thought in, which is a little unfortunate, but whatever. 50,000, like, I got a landing bonus of 15,000 because that pushed me up to 25k, and then I hit the media guy. Oh, come on, tell me I hit the media guy there, thank you. Let's see then, that was a, alright. Like, I don't know, I hate to keep harping on this, but I was really thinking I'd get almost no landing bonus for that first trick because I finished the flipping so high ahead, so high up from the ground. 7,000 point landing bonus there. Eight 8,000 there because I went from 5k to 13k and then doubled that. Like, I don't know. You could see how this would be really annoying in the pro events where you might have to rely on getting 5,000 points of landing bonus to beat a pro score. Like, 8k, I went from 8k to 22k to double that to 44k. Alright, I'm done talking about it, but Yeah, like, I don't know, you just ride and you just get a good line and it feels good. Like I said, I don't know how far I'll go. I probably won't get through everything I can, you know, in one stream. But, hey, you know, at what point should I stop? If I'm having fun and you're having fun, I guess maybe when I get hungry, because I didn't really think about that. It's funny how far ahead of the knuckle you land. I don't know what that means, Lego. Could you kind of explain? I don't know all the terminology. Must be very hard landings. Like, yeah, I don't know what that means. I mean, the hard landings part I kind of know, but if there's something I'm missing, like if you know the way to easy, easy points, please tell me. Finished around with the sponsor feeling amped. I could hit X to do don't show again, but whatever, it's not that bad. Spins and flips. Oh man. I like how the guy, like, when he starts out on the downslope, he just, like, leaps into the air. Doesn't land in the landing zone. What? I mean, I guess, like, there I kind of land on the down. I guess I'm still a little confused, but whatever. I remember, like, Amped 1, I was really confused about when I was even doing corkscrews and rodeos for the first few episodes, because, like, the game has a bad habit of not telling you stuff until you hit the ground. Like, there, I went from a 360 to 540 only when I landed. There, it showed rodeo while I was in the air, but I was really confused for a while, and that's one of those things. Maybe I should have played the game a bit more before actually recording. You know, some games that I haven't played before, I basically play to start the LP, you know, like Mad Dash Racing, I'm sure. Actually, I don't know about Mad Dash Racing, but some games, like, what am I trying to say? Yeah, if I played them an extra day or two beforehand, maybe I'd figure some stuff out. But I kind of gotta, you know, be a little workmanlike in my approach to this. Do I snowboard? No. I did sometimes as a kid, like once every winter, the parents would go to some artificial snow hill and, you know, put the little kiddos on skis and snowboards and see if they have fun, which usually for me ended up crashing everywhere. I have really bad balance. As much as I like extreme sports, I didn't actually do any of them as a kid. Oh, damn. I liked that line. Ha. I love it when I land on the power rails. Like, every level in Amped, you could see has, like, telephone wires or ski gondola wires going down it. Will I play Transworld Snowboarding for the channel or live? Because I have played it for the channel. Live? Maybe. I mean, like, I'm replaying Amped because it was such a strange game that I think I could have done better. Transworld Snowboarding was clunky enough that I'd probably have the same experience playing it again. So, I don't know. Maybe. Maybe. This is really for revisiting stuff that maybe I should give another chance. It's like, maybe this, Amped 2, maybe Dave Mira. I don't know. Stuff that I feel maybe with more knowledge I could do better, or, you know, kind of public opinion is different than my opinion. Oh, baby. Landed. Oh, yes. That was good. I liked that. It's kind of hard to intentionally transfer rail to rail. Which sucks when some of the pro jumps want you to do that. Huh, I'm hitting all of them. I'm not intending to do this, boys. Can't really hear this song. What is this? Showdown Dub by Filibuster. Bah. Bonus track. Yeah, like the Ziggins. Like, I'll be kind of quieter for this.
Ba, ba,
Yeah, I remember this song. I thought this one was in the sequel, actually. Just the way you are. Like, this band's just fun. Like, just a couple genres that, if you made this game, like, 5 years later, wouldn't even be included. Like, who cared about ska after, like, early 2000s? Ba, 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 da, da. In real life, to land a trick on a kicker, you need a steep landing zone hill, or else you will break your legs. Yeah, I mean, I know that, you know, you want to land on a downslope. I guess maybe in this game... Maybe, is that one of the factors? Like, if you land on a downslope and not just, like, on flat ground? Because I haven't really been thinking about that. I just kind of been tricking where there's opportunities to, but... Oh, shit. Oh! Oh, my God, I landed that. Okay. Yeah. Welcome to Amped 1, everybody. Check this sheesh. I'm just gonna, I'm gonna take a drink. Alright, I think I'm stuck here unless I spin. Hello? I mean, I could hit back to reset, but this is pretty funny. Oh, there we go. Yeah, going slow is hard in Amped, because even at the really low speed I'm at, like, you hit X, you know, you hold jump, and your guy just goes. He just starts going. Like, my advice back in my Let's Play was put, like, 2 or 3 points in speed max, because you're never too slow to hit something. Yep, welcome to Amped. That wasn't as weird, but... Okay, we're just gonna round out the gamut of weird tricks here. Like that, I don't know, like... I don't know, like, you know, it's just shit's happening. Welcome to Amped. Like, just gonna keep saying it. Like, it's, yeah, it's hard to go slow. I don't think I could intentionally go slow off some of these jumps. Or, if I do, that would require me to basically retrain myself, so I'm just gonna go with what works, but... 1 million points when caught in a glitch. I got a negative 1 million points by putting on a bunch of cheat codes, and... Well, I'm sure Blank Tester can explain more if he wants to, but... The game actually overflows the integers, if you get high enough. Touching telephone, touching gondola wires is just a bad time overall. Which I guess is kind of a good risk-reward thing, because you get sick grinds if you land on them, but if you don't land on them, you just get knocked around. It's not like you pass through them if you don't grind them. Which, like, an SSX game, you just pass through them. Actually, an SSX game, you just land on them no matter what. You don't have to hit a grind button. I'm really not doing a lot of tweaks, but the guy's A-okay with what I'm doing, so... Alright, no fucking around. I don't want to go too slow on the game either, so... Maybe when I go to Stratton and I just play around for high scores, I'll try to, you know, go slower or whatever, but like I said, it's kind of hard to do so at, you know, the speed your character's at anyway. Go slow by holding the left or right triggers. Well, yeah, that'll change your stance. I guess you're saying to do that right before a ramp or something, or just keep doing that. Like, I guess let's try it out. No, see, I did it too far away, I think. I don't know, I'll have to test your advice. But at least for a while, at least until you start getting into the, you know, part twos of the areas, doing what. No, don't press it all the way in. Just a little, oh shit. You reminded me of Amped 2 and, like, where you go off jumps and you half hold the left stick, half hold the right stick, half hold a grab button to do all the style shit and just, ugh, all the wires in your brain are crossing at once. It's hard. It's hard to do that. Pro one. Alright, let's try this out. This seems like something I kind of want to see. Like, okay, so... Oh, okay. Yeah. See, I didn't know that about this game. I didn't know you could do that. So you do it kind of right before the jumps, and then you can go slower. I haven't really done that much, so I'll have to figure out where it's most applicable. Go. Yeah, I see what you're saying now, though. That's kind of cool. I thought the switching stance was just you did it no matter what. I didn't know, like, you could kind of just slow down a little. That's new. Thanks for telling me that. Infinite air controls are hard. I heard that... Ooh, 4 of 11, I should restart. Yeah, no fucking around, I'm just gonna do this how I know it. I heard Mark McMorris' Infinite Air was, more technical. You know, Steep was kind of more like the SSXs, where you could just do crazy cool stuff. And again, I haven't really heard much about Mark McMorris' thingy, like... I don't know, I've seen some videos of people playing with the level editor, but it's a game that seems to have come out, period. You know, games kind of like that, where it comes out and doesn't really get, like, a huge following or whatever. Ow. Huh, see, like, I got a really big landing bonus and that saved my tail on that one. Not that I needed to get that one. Oh, Taco Bell. But, like, 10,000 points off that tiny kicker can be, quite a shit show. That one I just didn't get much air, but... I'll point out when there's, pro jumps that are really annoying. I definitely did not think I'd get on the rail. Whatever. I don't need to get this. Like I said, I've still got two free misses. I mean, the thing about Amped 1 is it's more realistic, but it's not fully realistic. Like, if you want really realistic, play the old ESPN X Games snowboarding games, like the ones Konami made. Holy shit, those were frustrating in how realistic they were. Like, you know, you'd need to line up spinning on a jump perfectly or you'd overspin or underspin. Like, Amped, your guy kind of stops after a front flip or a back flip or a full spin, you know, and you could set up. But back in the ESPN X Games days, like, those games, you literally had to, like, know exactly how much to spin to land or you were basically fucked. I did not like those games. I did not do full LPs of them. I only covered one in a one-shot video. Stratton. Ah, man. Stratton's kind of a weird course. Like, they just have those oil pipeline rails, and it's... I don't know. Oh, 31k. I'll try to avoid the snowmen so that, like I said, I could maybe, Oh, shit. What? Welcome to Amped. Sometimes the trees just wreck you, and sometimes you're A-okay. If you haven't been able to tell, I kind of want to be able to get all the tricking high scores and media challenges out of the way in one run, but I fully realize that might not happen, so I'm okay with doing multiple. Surprised I got that. Is there a jump there? Yeah, there was. Too bad I wasn't able to see it, because this level's so fucking foggy. I wish I'd cut the fog down. Yeah, Stratton's probably my least favorite area. I mean, just because of the fog, kind of, you know, you can't really see your opportunities that well until they're already sort of there. Think to that. Yeah, and that got me up to full points right at the end. Cool. Like, I just kind of like the surf rock sort of. It's like that Miserloo song from Guitar Hero. This is cool. 9 watching, 2 thumbs up. Thank you, boys. If you're just lurking, not saying anything, I mean, it'd be cool to see you around. See, like, I'm 4 in speed, like, and this is, I'll go up to 5, and then I think we're done with speed. As you see, I prioritize balance and spin, basically. Balance, just because, you know, you want to stay on rails, of course, and then spin, because you have to do 720s, 1080s, triple flips in the later half of the game, so. Yeah, I haven't been noticing Switch at all. Maybe it's such a minor thing, but maybe there's a trend. Like, when I'm Switch and I do tricks, I get less points. I don't know. But it's a really minor thing, and I wouldn't expect the average player to pick that up. Pam, the DC hero. It's not Superman, not Batman, but Pam. Likes rails. Oh, shit. Oh! I actually did not intend to jump onto that. Like, I really didn't think we'd make it. See, like, with balance, I can do this cool shit. Bust that sick shit so the guy, you know, thinks it's pretty nice. It's, pretty good. In the words of the immortal iDubbbz. And I mean that. That kid's found the super secret serum. I shouldn't be letting you guys know, but I feel like I have to spread the word. Never start. Ow. Never start, you know, tricking until you know you can get on the rail. Huh, that was weird. Alright. Are we going forward? Whoa! Okay. Welcome to Amped. Nah, it's cool. I'm gonna jump off. I don't trust myself to get to the end of the rail. I mean, the fog just scares me, like, I feel like it doesn't give me enough time to really be able to set most things up. Though I really do like how you can spin around with the left stick and the triggers control your balance. Like, I've always said, I need to trick again. I can't just race to the end, but I like games where, you know, your balance isn't necessarily tied to what exactly what you do on the rail. So I like how you can spin around and keep your balance with separate buttons. You know, in most games, you're grinding and you're desperately trying to keep your balance with a thumbstick, and that's just not super fun. Kind of like the triggers a little more. I mean, I get that snowboarding, you don't have wheels on the bottom, so it's not like, not like skateboarding. It's like spins and flips. Yeah, if I remember right, this is kind of a tough sponsor, but still not super tough, because like spins and flips doesn't mean you have to do them in the air only. Like, you can spin around on a rail and have a lot of fun. Handling the slow speed like a pro? If you think this is a pro, then I'm flattered. Oh, shit. Huh, only 3. I thought I was gonna be... Okay, 4. Right, 1 right at the end. But yeah, if you think this is pro gameplay, then I'm flattered, because this is just me kind of cruising along and seeing what happens. I mean, I'm pretty good at extreme sports games, but Amped, if I remember right, this Amped 1 and Amped 2 just gives everyone the business. Totally thought I was going to get on that. Should have spun there. I couldn't see the fucking... I'm super surprised I didn't get wrecked there. That was a really early jump. Ah, fuck. Yeah, I'm kind of fucking it up right here at the end. See, like, I can barely see the fucking jump in front of me. Come on, Stratton. Alright. I need to bust some sick shit right here at the end. Did it? Nah, it didn't get me high enough. Go for triple backflip. I don't think I have the stats to do that. I think I need more spin flip. I don't think I'm at that point yet. Alright, we gonna land? Aw, I thought we were gonna land on the rail. That'd be cool. Yeah, this guy wants 720s or double backflips or cool shit. Barely. I could have maybe landed if I spun sideways, but I didn't want to risk it and crash outright. Oh, see, that worked out. There's something about, like, doing a backflip and then just doing a 180 or something like that, like, where that kind of helps, like, okay, woo, woo. I almost did a trick there. Fuck me. See, like, I jumped too late because I didn't know where the end of the fucking... I might have fucked this right at the end. Just, you fuck one thing up, and I know I'm swearing a lot. Like, you mess one jump in the game up, and then you just mess the next one. Like, you need to get back kind of in the rhythm. Oh, no. No, we tricked hard enough that the dude's amped. Woo! Try. I don't think there's any really huge jumps on Stratton 1 either. Stratton 2 has some pretty big ones, but I don't know where the big jumps on Stratton 1 are as well. Altabahn, though. I know the only place to do a 1260 jump. Altabahn has a bunch of huge jumps, so I'll try there. Because I think I'm done with getting stats for Stratton. Right? I mean, I'm doing the... Yeah, flew too close to the sun. You don't want to try and spin and do nose presses and shit too much. Am I? Apparently I was doing a nose press. Ow! Fuck. This is... kind of a weird area. I guess I didn't notice how much you just, like, go up rails even when you're, you know, going uphill on them. Oh, that was weird. You know, the game's being lenient with us today. Being lenient with us. Or maybe it's the game showing my skill. I gotta remember that you use the triggers to slow down, because, like, if you just hold back, you slow a little bit, which to me, I thought that was the way to do it, so... That's how I'm used to doing it. Because, again, I didn't even know about the triggers. Ow. Shit. You mean Flip? What's up, United Movie Makers? Oh, man. It's been a while since I've seen you comment on a video. I mean, that's not a diss against you. Just welcome back, bro. And again, in Amped 1, the dude's okay with you busting sick air tricks. Like... He likes rails, nose, tail presses, but he also likes a sick, double corkscrew, tail to nose bone. Oh, where I just cleared over the trees. That was cool and lucky. Oh, shit. Yeah, like, no way would I get a triple front flip, you know, in pretty much anywhere on this level. I'll try an Altabahn, like I said. I'll try an Altabahn. Alright, can I just rush to the bottom? Yeah. A good strategy in sponsor events. Get amped, and then if you're anywhere close to the bottom, just rush to the bottom. Hey, Robert Smith, what's up, man? Try triple backflip, I easily could have pulled it off. Dude, did you see how slow I was spinning, man? Like, Just give me like 5-10 minutes. I gotta do get pro one. Bjorn Lanes, 0 of 6. Oh shit. I can't see the fucking jump. I basically guessed that. Oh, well. Yeah. Like I said, next area I know there's a bunch of big jumps, so. Ah, darn. I didn't feel confident in my rail transfer skills, so. Oh shit, come on. Oh my god, I am a god. I am. Whew, I was not expecting that to work. But whatever. I had that beat as soon as I beat, like, the third thingy. Like, again, I cannot stress. You can miss three and keep going, and you don't have to beat the last one. So, if you've missed zero and you're on the. You're about to ride forward to the, you know, third to last event. You don't even need to get any more of those. What a land. Try. All right. So now I'm going to Altabahn, and I'll try there. Actually, let me change the music again, which I'll do. Yeah, let me change the music again. I'll switch it over to rapper. I don't want to do the electronic, because to me the electronic playlist is kind of boring. But I want to switch it up some. I don't really know what hip-hop rap songs they got for this game. So, oh, I hit the wrong button. I mean, I guess not the really wrong button, but... Did that go through? Yeah. No, I hit the right button. Wasn't one of the selling points was the soundtrack? Honestly, I don't know how they got so many songs on this game. They have, like, literally 250. Alright, Altabahn. Altabahn. I love Altabahn. It's probably my favorite level. Just because it's, you know, natural. You know, it doesn't have all the created kickers or whatever. And like I said, there's just something about jumping right up over a cliff face. I know there's a huge jump. Yeah, into the ravine. So I'll try for a triple flip here. Not like this jump, but on this level. How about... Okay, that was weird. If I'm gonna get a triple anywhere, it's on Altabahn. Ah, see, like, if I jumped a little late, I would have just cleared over the natural incline and I would have gotten a huge landing bonus. Alright, I think, here? I could have dropped more. Oh, hey, snowman. Huh. That was kind of weird and cool. Yeah, I think this is gonna 9,000, oh, no, I'd only went up to 11,000 before I doubled. See, like, I don't know. Sometimes I think I'm gonna get... You know, sick tricks, and I'll get okay tricks, and then sometimes I think I'm gonna botch it all, and I get like 40,000 landing bonus points. But I'll swing back and try to see. Like, don't tell me I could have gotten three there, unless there's a way to like preload even faster than I am. Whoever made the game might have been part of the label. Yeah, I mean, this game was made by Microsoft Xbox Studios, made in house. I went off the drop switch. All right. You know what? I'll put 2 points in a spin just for you, and, we're going to, we're gonna try... Oh my god, get this shit out of here. We're gonna try just for you, JH Lego. Just for you, baby, because I know there's a sick jump into the, ravine. I thought I could make something happen there. Yeah, I think I could get three. Let's see. All right, everybody. Put your hands together, summon spirit energy, just like in Dragon Ball Z. All right, we're doing it. We're doing it. How do you think about that? Boom. Shakalaka. Now you'll tell me to go do four, and I'll be like, huh. Did they just grab instrumentals? Where's the music? The Blood of Brimstone. I need to confirm. Alright. If that wasn't good enough, I'll try it again. But you better like that. I did a triple flip. Carl from Iris Marketing likes big air. Fuck it, we'll do another triple flip. Oh, but you see that? Like 23,000, because I coasted just over the rim and I landed pretty much on downslope. Oh shit, I'm switch. Alright, let's do this. Yeah, I wouldn't be able to get four. You saw how slow I was going at the end there. Alright. Oh shit, that was really cool. I'm doing a lot of really cool things this playthrough, which I wasn't really able to do the first time around. Like, if you watch my LP of Amped, I was kind of just rolling with what I got, kind of just dealing with kind of getting tossed around. I'm like kind of Keanu Reeves style doing some sick Matrix shit on this playthrough. That wasn't big air enough for you? Nah, I'm too far in. The thing about this canyon is it doesn't give you a ton of opportunities. You know what? Let's see how much Switch affects things. Some, but not a whole ton. Or at least that wasn't very conclusive. I default to the stale fish, and I don't know why. Like, whether I'm Switch or not, I go the stale fish. Like, even though I don't have any tweaks for that yet. Like, I could just take it easy and, do nose grab, tail grab, but... Yeah, but I really like Altabahn. Like, it's kind of natural flow. Just makes the jumps kind of, you know, just cooler in a way, rather than riding down the, you know, the manufactured tracks of the other, areas. Maybe it's because of different. Then four flips. Also, think about doing the Time Splitters LP. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez, Rick. Oh, jeez. You're gonna have to shove them all the way up your ass, Morty. But, 9 seasons. Even if it takes 9 seasons, we're gonna get that Szechuan sauce. Szechuan. I don't know fucking how to say it. But, Time Splitters LP, yeah. I was thinking, and this was a thought I had, like, the first couple years of this extreme sports thing before I realized just how long it would go. I was thinking how maybe once I was done with the extreme sports thing, I would do, like, you know, other genres, but I wouldn't pick specific genres. I was thinking I'd do, like, go to the game store, because again, this was during college, before, you know, I had any ideas of where I would end up afterwards. And everything was perfect and cool, and I could hang out late and, you know, go to my classes and put in minimal effort. But I had an idea where I'd just pick 5 or so random games from the used game store. Like, because there's a bunch, like, PS2, Xbox, GameCube, you know, that was the days of pretty much anyone could make a console game. Not anyone, but there was a lot of kind of bottom tier stuff, strange stuff that people might not have heard about. So, where was I going? So I was thinking I'd pick, you know, random games and kind of check them out. Obviously that's not Time Splitters because, you know, Time Splitters is well known, but maybe at some point I'll do more than just extreme sports games. I need to see. If there's not a good Time Splitters LP out there, it'll be higher up on my list, because, like I said, I kind of like to show off what people don't know about. Like, before I did Amped and Amped 2 Let's Plays, there really weren't full game coverages, or, you know, you could see, you know, some events and some levels, but it was people filming their TV. You can get a one extra 180 spin? Yeah, I know about that. I guess I don't use that super often. Because I think the game penalizes against that. I feel like it gives less, you know, less good landing bonuses. Oh, right, I'm supposed to tweak. Less good landing bonuses if you do that. Like, especially, you know, Amp 2 is all about smooth style and such. And I know that game, I think, would punish you for trying to do something like that. God, I keep doing the stale fish, even though, well, actually, I do have one tweak. But that's one. Time Slayer's being remembered, not as big. See ya? Oh, yeah, you gotta go to bed or something. Alright, peace, Alt-F4. Thanks for stopping by, man. Yeah. Time Slayer's 4, there's lots of people, or Time Splitters in general, there's lots of people who love Time Splitters, but just not enough to get it back off the ground. You know? Like, there was talks of bringing it back, but just not enough people to get, like, remastered versions or another game, you know. Just enough to generate interest, but not actually convince people to do it. I got a bunch of comments. Bowser found me through Sean Palmer, looking for a guide. Yeah, that's kind of why I'm here, not only to show, especially back then at the start. Back then in the first few games I did, I was especially more like a visual game facts than a Let's Player, you know? The commentary, especially in Sean Palmer, was all like, now do this, now do this. Oh, if I remember right, I think this is one of the first pro events that really kind of can fuck you. So it'll be interesting. This is where I want to try all the different things and try to get points. Spin to Win, yeah, and then Movie Makers. Yeah, I mean, I just played extreme sports a ton as a kid, and it felt like there wasn't a lot of coverage on YouTube. You know, like JetX2O, I couldn't find any coverage before I did my Let's Play. I'm sorry, are we still doing hip-hop? Because this doesn't sound like a hip-hop song. Maybe I fucked up the soundtracks. Ah, right into the tree. After all that shit, just a nice little jump. So there's a lot of the PS2, Xbox. Yeah, the PS1, N64 generation, especially PS1, N64, you know, you had less. You didn't have as many crossover games, but then, yeah, those two generations were really when it took off, and I've been playing different games for 5 years, and like I said, haven't even touched PS1. That's got Dave Mira 1, Matt Hoffman 1, a whole bunch of you know, games and that maybe came out but didn't leave that much of an impact. Not like today where they're novel. Yeah, there were thoughts that SSX 2012 could maybe light a fire, but obviously it didn't really happen. It was kind of crazy. We got Steep and Mark McMorris Infinite Air sort of at the same time, after really nothing. You know, Xbox 360, PS3 started, you got Amped 3, and like some motocross games. I guess motocross games have always sort of stayed, you know, being released. The, you know, the MX vs. ATV series. But like snowboarding, You got Amped 3, Sean White, Stoked. You don't really hear a lot about Stoked, but that was a game that came out as well. What else? And then, God, I remember this rock. I remember this rock used to confuse the shit out of me first time around, and because I didn't think you could jump off the side of those, but now I just know what to do, you know? Benefits of hindsight. You know, you get to revisit it, and you get to actually do the game justice. But then it kind of stopped after those games. Then, like I said, Pure, if you have a Xbox or 360 or a PS3 and you haven't played the game Pure, ATV racing game, you really should. It's a great game. But, now it's kind of get... There's so many options on this level that I just kind of get overloaded and ride by all of them without really picking any one. But, sorry, I'm. Woo-wee! I should have prepared some fast food for me to eat or something, you know? I guess we could take a out to get food break soon. Because I've been going for an hour and a half, and I'm all the way up at slope style, almost hit Pro 2. Pro 2 is when I've got to go back and do those Pro 2s on a bunch of tracks. Championship Motocross featuring Ricky Carmichael. I had a Travis Pastrana motocross game for the PS1 as a kid. Hey, Blank Tester, you're still in here. I mean, what's up, you know? Yeah, I might call for a food break after I get Pro 2 on these events. I just didn't plan this super well, and I'm getting hungry, so. That'll still be, I gotta do 3 sponsors here, and then the Pro 1 event, I think, before I unlock Pro 2. And I'll do the Pro 2 event while I'm here. Though I remember the Pro 2 for this track was really hard, if I remember right. So that might take some attempts. Okay, that was weird. Welcome to Amped, everybody. But, you know, if there's... You guys know that I do my Let's Plays post-commentary, so I don't do comm while recording. Mainly because I'm not super great at talking while playing. I mean, you might think I'm doing fine, but, you know, trust me, sometimes I just have mental lapses and shit. Like, I run out of stuff to talk about after a while. And also, you know, I can't get a ton of guests while doing live. But, fuck me, if I did live comm back when I did Amped and Amped 2, there'd be fucking rage. Like, remember, Bob, like, Amped 2, every level I'd call you over to watch an event that was just a piece of complete bullshit. So, you guys were spared from all that, except for maybe my Pro 3 video, where I got legit remission angry while watching the gameplay again. Oh my fuck. JH Lego, how did you feel about the, Pro 3 challenges for this game? Because, oh shit, I think we're good. Yep. Yes. Barely. Woo! Yeah, but JH Lego, what'd you feel about Pro 3? Because that's where some real horse honky comes in. Oh! I hit Pro 2 off of that. Right. Because the Pro levels don't have 3 sponsors. Pro 2. The Pro 2s are really where this game and... Actually, Amped 2, the Follow the Line challenges were even worse, but Pro 2s are where this game starts taking off into the bullshit stratosphere, so it's been a good warm-up. We're kind of gonna do the warm-up and then break for food and then come back to just a bunch of bullshit right in a row. I did Stillfish even though there's no tweaks. Oh, wow. See, I fucked that up. You're like right here, 2 orange tricks in a row. Like, you gotta do a ton of points here. there's kind of something about getting points about where, like, I start off diagonal, and then if I rotate to just doing spins or just doing flips, it kind of gives me more points. Except for that, where I guess even though I was holding down to do a flip, the guy was perfectly content just spinning his fucking heart away. But yeah, like, if I need a bunch of points, there's kind of something about starting like a corkscrew and then turning it into either a spin or a flip where that seems to get you more points than just doing a double corkscrew or whatever. I don't know. Oh, I crashed, but I landed. Yeah. MTX Moto Tracks. That game, I'll just say it's coming up soon. I think it's coming up soon. Oh shit, I'm really not doing this event very well. Fuck. Ow. I'm gonna fuck this. If I can get this guy, then I'll have won. Oh my, what the fuck? 2,000 to 15,000? How? I really want to know how to harness this power for good and not for average. Hungry though? Alright. Let's see, I'm at Pro 2 now, but I'm right here, so let me see if I can beat Pro 2. If I can, then we'll take a break and go get some food. Oh, fucking right, this jump sucks shit. Okay, watch this. Shit, you haven't posted well. JH Lego. If you're watching, check this, because man, this event sucks balls. The guy wants you to go up here, but like, how did that not give me enough points? I double flipped. And you want to get that one, because usually, like, there's not enough room to land both the first trick and the second. Like, fuck it, I'm gonna fuck that up. But like, the second trick is right here. Like, you have no room. And I'd rather get one of these. So I remember I came up with some bullshit way to do the first trick where I basically cheesed it. Trick levels being difficult, like, cheesed it, where like the circle goes past where you think it does, so like you could just ride forward and jump right at the edge of the shit. But like, look, the guy starts and he just hops the fuck up. Like, I'm not telling him to do that. Like, he's deciding to do that, and that really cuts the amount of time where I can get over and make a good jump on this first one. And I'd rather hit this one, because I think this jump is easier overall than the second. Like, see, I jumped really late, but... and I didn't get enough points. What the fuck? Alright. Time to pay attention to how many points I actually need, because maybe I'm just really underestimating this. Wow, I'm sorry. Alright, I needed 9,000. I guess I kept constantly getting just too little, because I was getting scores of 9,000. Yeah, like, this event is just the start of bullshit tier. Pros, I don't think they intended to do this, but all of the pro events where it's female snowboarders, those are the really bullshit ones, like, in this game. I don't know if they intended to do it, but there's pretty much a one-to-one correlation between female boarder and god-awful pro challenge. It's just kind of funny. So yeah, I consider myself already kind of thin ice on this challenge here, because I think there's like a really hard jump near the end. Oh fuck. Oh, I landed it. Okay. All right, I made it. I made it through. Because again, you can miss three and be fine. So, all right. I'm gonna take a food break. With the power of OBS, I can actually. I should change that from Incitic will begin shortly. Please tell me I can change that while it's streaming. Alright. Return slowly. I mean shortly. But, alright, I'm gonna run out and get food. Why is that off key? I wanna check to make sure it's up. Yeah. What the fuck? Move over. Oh, I just did. Yeah, I'm just, my stream when I check it is behind like 30 seconds. All right. Food break. We will be back in, well, when I go get food and eat it. If I die along the way, rep wrist and flip in peace. Bob gets all my stuff. Probably can't get into my apartment though. Well, I guess you could find my dead body, which will have my keys on it. But I'll be back in 15 to 20 minutes.